varied programme for you. Obviously, what you're looking forward to is Greg Douglas and the Pompetus of Love. But first of all, something very special. A friend of mine, Chris Gregory, he's going to do something which will probably be very unusual for you, but you're going to enjoy it immensely. Can you hear it, please, for Chris Gregory?
I said to John, 3 minutes, John.
That's so
he
important.
Walked straight in, you know, amateur.
Time keeps on slipping into the future, doesn't it? Just the same.
Yeah, that's what same with you. Just sorting that out now.
Anyone know any jokes?
No? Don't ask.
Hello, good evening, and welcome. That is the question, isn't it?
That is the question.
Okay, you ready for some poems?
Yes!
Okay, the first one is called Mask.
So am I.
Swept up and carried on the backs of impossible beasts. Horn and claw are raised, the tails sway. Who is hiding behind this mask? Is it me or is it someone disguised as me? A mask or a person? A mask or a person? Perspectives are torn, out of shape, some are withdrawn, but nothing escapes the architecture's demands that its cries will be heard above the roaring of the crowd. I'm lost in a word. Who is hiding behind this mask? Is it me? Or is it someone disguised as me? A mask or a person? A mask or a person? Smoke is pouring out of the earth. Banners are trampled in their headlong rush. The onward marching feet, the thunder of hooves that fills my ears as the face behind that mask disappears, pouring out of my mouth. Who is hiding behind this mask? Is it me or is it someone disguised as me? A mask or a person? A mask or a person? No one remembers. A memory is wiped out. The whiteness hangs in an envelope. Meaning is loosened. My grip is gone. I open my eyes. I open my eyes. I am alone. So who was hiding behind that mask? Was it me? Or was it someone disguised as me? Or a person, a mask, or a person, a mask, or a person.
Yes.
Okay, so we've got poems for all kinds of people tonight. This one's for the intellectuals in the audience. We've got the intellectuals. No, I didn't think so. That's all right. Thank God for that. This one. It's called Shakespeare in the Ghetto. Shakespeare in the Ghetto. I'm sat on the night, so cool and slick in the flickering candlelight. In the King's Head Tavern, he dances like a devil till early light. Outside, the hungry dogs are howling. The pimps and the hustlers withdraw into the shadows, out of sight. Shakespeare in the Ghetto, there's a knocking at the door. The landlady is scowling. Rats scatter on the floor. She's complaining about his pacing up and down. The scratching of his quill, that repetitive sound. He shrugs and throws her a penny. The face of Gloriana, now dead. And then he retreats into his lodgings. Ancient voices spinning round in his head. So he dreams. So he dreams of magical potions, transformations, strange concoctions from far off lands. And so he dreams of magical potions, strange concoctions, transformations from far off lands. Shakespeare in the Ghetto, when the morning comes, stumbles through the streets, ignoring the bums who writhe around the cobbles at his feet. Shakespeare's lost and lonely. His lost dark lady has taken off to Italy. His mates try to consult him with more cold ale. Shakespeare takes a deep breath as the streets begin to wake. Visions appear in front of his eyes. Cold white horses passing, cold white horses passing, cold white horses passing, like flashes of lightning in disguise. So he dreams. So he dreams. So he dreams. Dreams of magical potions, transformations, strange concoctions from far off lands. And so he dreams of magical potions, strange concoctions from far off lands. Shakespeare's in the graveyard, holding up his skull. Got your number, your entrance is set. This is what he wants to know. Whether it is nobler to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune or not, he'll never be out of his debt. You'll never be out of his debt. Never be out of his debt. Okay, this one's a tribute to somebody who we all miss. And somebody we all miss. We're going to see a picture of him in a minute. You're probably going to know who he is in a minute, because we're going to hear...
We know who he is. Keep up, Mark.
David Bowie. The vacant space upon the stage, the star-crowned silhouette, twisting, turning, to transparent shapes. A toss of knowing locks, the piercing unearthly eyes, the cut-up shapes of newsprint words thrown up into the skies, cascading, falling into whatever random shapes they may take. The quicksands falling, skinny dogs howling at ghetto moons, the teeming mice in their million hordes, a glimpse of whiteness in the ice cream parlour. Two brothers lost in the mind warp pavilion, in ever-changing, rearranging, distorted shapes in the carnival mirror. The lonely pilot drifting out of sight, the image dimming as the speck of light diminishes further and further into the infinite night. But the voice is still insistent, multi-tracked in heaven's high, in a chorus of itself. Look up, look up! If you hold out your hand, perhaps you will catch the prettiest star falling, falling, falling to earth. So this is the one for all the hippies and weirdos in the audience. We got any of those?
No, they're with the intellectuals.
No, 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 it's in the wrong place, really. This is called Sunset at Castlereagh.
I think the intellectual.
Castlereagh's a stone circle up north, where I come from. First, I lay my warm hands on every cold stone, weaving in and out, gathering pace, until I gravitate to the absolute epicentre of the circle. Then I stand stock still, facing north, facing east, facing west, facing south. Already, I'm shadowed by the overwhelming crags that are closing in on me, enfolding me. Darkness is falling. I can feel the wind caress my skin. And then, as the earth beneath my feet begins to shake, I begin to spin, gathering pace again. Faster and faster, faster and faster, faster and faster, until my feet feel lighter and lighter, and the universe inside me bursts into radiant light. I am a cosmos! And then the dance begins to form. The naked dancers surround me. They take my hand, and we cascade into concentric circles. Inside circles, inside circles. Stars explode, whole galaxies come into being and wink out one by one. All around, the drums beat louder and louder until the drummer's hands disappear into a blur. I open my eyes, the new moon rises. I can feel my bare feet sinking down into the earth. I'm standing absolutely still as the planet revolves around me. Now, and only now, can I reach up my hands and kiss the sky?
That one as well.
This is for you. This one's called Nazi Zombies on the Moon.
Oh yeah, we'll do that. That's true.
It's a very broken line, it's back to you, Chris. When this is coming.
No. I'm not going to see this girl.
You don't even know they're there. You probably don't know that you should be scared. You can live your life in ignorance, ignoring the cosmic significance of signs up in the sky and mysterious strangers passing by. And you can try to conceal the hidden truth about to be revealed by those who are in the know half-human ghosts you meet when you go to the darkest parts of the dark, dark net, where the secrets you wanted to forget are brought out from the darkest night, straight out from the darkest night, straight out into the blinding light. But you better wise up soon, you better wise up soon, because there's Nazi zombies on the moon! Nazi zombies on the moon! If you look around, you'll see what I mean. They're out there, on the dance floor, in every magazine. They're making sure their money's well spent. They've even taken over the president. It's really good to hear. They've got their claws into everything. Watch the X Factor, watch them sing. They're trying to infiltrate your brain. Very soon they'll drive you insane. They'll lurk behind you at the ATM, send your PIN number to the faceless men who are registering your every thought, who know about everything you've bought. They've got your passwords, everyone. They're storing them up. Soon, all your money will be gone. They'll colonise your bank accounts into ever smaller, ever diminishing amounts. So you better wise up soon. You better wise up soon. There's Nazi zombies on the moon. Nazi zombies on the moon. You may not want to believe, but you can't even conceive of the conspiracies concealed behind the cipher shields, erected by the brainwashed minions, the ones with no opinions, the ceaseless lines of clones, the endless lines of drones, manning the telephone lines, ignoring the blatantly obvious signs. NASA's infiltration into the heart of the nation. NASA's hidden plan to turn every message into spam. They're sending out their spooks to turn every word to gobbledygook. So you better wise up soon. You better wise up soon. You better evacuate the room. There's Nazi zombies on the moon. Nazi zombies on the moon. Nazi zombies on the moon. This is a religious poem, and if there's any religious people out there, but this is a particular type of religion, and I hope you've got to, you know, follow the right path after this. Through the dim graveyard mist, the Cadillacs purr by, their windows blacked out. Inside, grey hoods rolled up, hooded eyes behind shades, a thick Havana haze. In the crack house down on Lonely Street, an off-duty hooker prostrates herself before the frozen image of the king. The sneer, the upturned eyebrow, hair shining in sleek black light, mouthing the holy words, "Love me, tender." The word is out. The king is risen. Arrangements have been made. The rights have gone explicitly to Coca-Cola. Already, the mountains of crushed cans and styrofoam cartons, each one emblazoned with the face of the sacred one, are being swept away. Tonight, in Disneyland, he will rise again, bathe in laser beams and fireworks, flanked by Mickey Mouse, Michael Jackson, Madonna, and God. Oh, Pictures coming in a minute. Pictures are very important, you know. Like pictures. You all right? Enjoying yourselves this evening?
Yeah.
You good? Good? One more party to go. Then we'll have Steve Miliband. Our faces at the edge of the forest are wolves gazing into a darkness that covers us as it swells into a full dance of shadow. The only light here is the light that seems to come through eyes of wolves, gleaming inwardly, impervious to the coming of night. To the coming of night. We are waiting for the safety of the dawn, when the wolves will have feasted and their shadows will have gone into darkness to be reunited with the whiteness of the sun. Thank you very much.